In the past, I have commented on a famous quote by John Eccles, which, to the best of my memory, goes somewhat like this: I want you to know that there are no colors in the real world, there are no fragrances in the real world, that there is no beauty and there is no ugliness. Out there, beyond the limits of our perceptual apparatus, is the erratically ambiguous and ceaselessly flowing quantum soup. And we're almost like magicians in that, in the very act of perception, we take the quantum soup and we convert it into the experience of material reality in our ordinary, everyday waking state of consciousness. So, this is a quote that I have used before. And although Sir John Eccles was what you call dualist, mind-body interactionalist, his ideas on quantum soup were very interesting to me and actually reinforced the non-dualistic view. So Eccles' description of reality as quantum soup was likely influenced by several factors, such as one, quantum mechanics. The field of quantum physics revealed that at the subatomic level, reality is fundamentally uncertain and probabilistic rather than deterministic. Number two, limitations of sensory perception. Eccles recognized that human senses capture only a tiny fraction of the total energy in the environment, less than one part per billion. Number three, the subjective experience of perception. He understood that different organisms perceive reality differently based on their sensory apparatus, suggesting there's no single objective reality. Number four, non-materiality of the atomic world. The realization that atoms, the basic units of matter, are mostly empty space with energy states rather than solid particles. And number five, consciousness studies. Eccles' work in neuroscience and his interest in the mind-brain problem likely contributed to his perspective on the role of consciousness in shaping our perception of reality. So, is the understanding of reality as quantum soup of any significance? What are the several potential benefits? Here they are. Number one, enhanced creativity and problem solving. Viewing reality as a fluid, probabilistic state of possibilities rather than a fixed deterministic system can inspire more creative thinking and novel approaches to problem solving. Number two, which is, of course, very popular these days, improved manifestation techniques. The concept of quantum soup aligns with theories of quantum manifestation, suggesting that our thoughts and intentions can influence the quantum field and shape our reality. Number three, advanced technological applications. Quantum computers, which operate based on quantum principles, can model reality more precisely than classical computers, potentially leading to breakthroughs in fields like biology and material sciences. Number four, enhanced understanding of consciousness. The observer effect in quantum physics implies that consciousness plays a role in shaping reality, offering new perspectives on the nature of mind and its interactions with the physical world. Number five, more holistic worldview. Recognizing the entanglement of all things at the quantum level can foster a more unified understanding of reality, potentially bridging gaps between science, philosophy, and spirituality. Number six, improved error correction in quantum computing. Research has shown that understanding quantum principles can lead to the creation of new phases of matter with enhanced protection against errors in quantum computers potentially advancing the field of quantum computing. And number seven, new approaches to modeling complex systems. The quantum soup concept can inspire new ways of modeling and understanding complex interconnected systems in various fields, from ecology to economics. Wow, that's pretty impressive, right? Well, anyway, I'm reading this book right now, Matter, the Magnificent Illusion by Guido Tonnelli. I'm trying to track this author. Guido Tonnelli is a prize-winning physicist and one of the leaders in the discovery of the Higgs boson. He's a professor of general physics at the University of Pisa and physicist at the European Organization for Nuclear Research, CERN, in Geneva. So if any of you knows how to get in touch with him, which I'm trying to do so, I think we could have an excellent conversation on these channels. Okay, quantum soup is the topic for today. The ultimate reality is not even quantum soup. It is the consciousness that uses the quantum soup to manifest what we call material reality. But it's all illusion. Okay, friends, if you find this useful, let me know. And this is the book I'm promoting right now. And you can continue to engage with me, if you wish, by going to deepakchopra.ai, my digital twin. Let's have a conversation.